Welcome to Flights of Fancy Storytime. I'm Anne, and I'm here to bring some of the National Air and Space Museum stories to you at home. Today's story is about the solar system. A system is when different things work together in specific ways to do something. And solar means the sun. So the solar system is full of different planets and other things that work together and orbit around the sun. There are lots of different planets in the solar system of all sizes and shapes. There are rocky planets like our Earth, and the giant planets that are farther away. There are smaller asteroids and dwarf planets in the asteroid belt, and there are icy worlds way out in the Kuiper belt with Pluto. All of these worlds stay in their own places and orbit around the sun. It's kind of like a big family. At the National Air and Space Museum, we sometimes like to think of the solar system as the family of the sun. And here's a story about that. Once upon a time, there was a planet called Mercury. She was a small, rocky planet and very speedy. She would orbit very quickly around the sun. One day, while she was orbiting, she heard the sun say that Earth was not feeling well. Mercury got very worried and wanted to check on them to make sure that they were doing okay. Sun said, "Don't worry, Earth will be okay." But Mercury did worry. Unfortunately, even though she was very speedy, she had to stay in her orbit and she couldn't travel to visit Earth. She called out to her sister Venus. Venus was rocky too, a little bigger than Mercury and very bright. "Venus," Mercury shouted, "how are you?" "I'm fine, thank you, Mercury. How are you?" replied Venus. "I'm fine, but I'm worried about Earth. I heard they aren't feeling well," said Mercury. "Okay," said Venus. "I'll check in on them next time I pass by in my orbit, and I can check on Mars too." On her way to Earth, Venus spied Mars off in the distance. Mars was rocky and rusty red in color, but that was normal for him. Venus called out, "Hey, Mars, how are you?"
"I'm chillin', how are you?" replied Mars.
"Good, but I heard Earth isn't feeling well. Have you heard anything from the asteroid belt?"
"Oh, you know them. They're all zipping around, busy and chatting with each other. Ceres says hello," said Mars.
"Well, good. We'll talk to you later."
"Later," said Mars.
Then Venus saw Earth. "Earth," she called, "are you okay? Mercury was asking about you."
"Oh, thanks," said Earth. "I think I have a temperature and I'm feeling a little blue, but I'll be better soon."
"How is everybody else in the family?" Venus said, "I've been checking in on everyone, and so far everyone is okay."
So Venus reported back to Mercury, "Earth is okay, and all the other inner planets are okay too."
"Good," said Mercury, "but what about the giant planets and the Kuiper belt? They're so far away, they might not know that Earth isn't feeling well. How can we check in on them?"
Venus said, "Let's send the Zoom spaceship. It can travel all the way to the end of the solar system and check in on the whole family."
"Oh, that would make me feel so much better," said Mercury. So they prepared the Zoom spaceship.
Zoom spaceship, a robot spacecraft, could travel very far away and report back. "Zoom spaceship, ready for duty," it beeped. "Mission, family check-in. First stop, Uncle Jupiter." It sped off to Jupiter.
"Greetings, Jupiter. Mercury and the inner planets would like to know, how are you doing?"
Uncle Jupiter replied in his big, low voice,
"Oh, how nice of them to check in. I'm gassy as usual, but I have all my moons to keep me company. Hello, Mercury. Get well soon, Earth."
"Next stop, Saturn," beeped Zoom. Saturn was all dressed in glittery, icy rings.
"Hello. Auntie Saturn is always happy to hear from you all. Give my love to Earth. Hugs."
All of her moons waved as well.
"On to Uranus," and Zoom sped off to the next planet. Uranus gleamed an icy blue color as he spun on his side.
"Hey," said Uranus, "we're cooling out here, doing our own thing, you know. Good to hear from you. Feel better, Earth?"
It was getting very cold by the time Zoom's spaceship caught up with bright blue Neptune. Zoom didn't mind. There was a mission to complete. It was hard to hear over the winds blowing on Neptune.
"I'm well, thanks. I love a windy day."
"All the best," said Neptune.
"I'll be on my way," said Zoom as it sped out to the Kuiper belt to check on Pluto and Charon and the others.
Pluto grinned and waved with the other icy worlds and moons.
Nice of you to come all the way out here to check on us. Get some rest and feel better, Earth, they all said together.
The Zoom spaceship mission was complete. It sped back to deliver all of the messages, past Neptune and Uranus, past Saturn and Jupiter, through the asteroid belt, and past Ceres, Mars, and it caught up with Earth.
Earth, beeped Zoom spaceship, how are you feeling?
Oh, thank you, I'm doing better, I think. Thanks for asking.
All of the family is thinking about you and hopes you feel better soon.
Earth thought, it's so nice of everyone to check in on me when I'm not feeling well. I will have to remember to let them know I care more often.
I'm heading back to Mercury, beeped Zoom spaceship, and it sped past Venus and back to Mercury.
Zoom spaceship mission report. Systems are operational. All is well.
Thanks, Zoom. I feel so much better now. Oh, I almost forgot. Hey, Sun, how are you? Said Mercury.
And the Sun just smiled and thought, I have a wonderful family.
It's craft time. Today we're going to make a family of the Sun, solar system, playset. This is the whole solar system fits inside of this container, which is the Sun on the outside. So if we open it up, I'll show you. So there's the Sun. And then we have Venus, Earth, Mars. Here's little Ceres from the asteroid belt.
Giant Jupiter.
Saturn. Uranus and Neptune, and of course, little Pluto in the icy worlds. You can play with these on a tabletop or on the floor, and then when you're finished, they go right back into the container to be put away next time. Now, to make this a craft activity, all you need is a takeout container like this one. You need some lids that you save from different things that you've eaten or used. And you need some paper, your tape, and your scissors, and some crayons or markers to color in your planets. First thing we're gonna do is we're going to make the Sun to decorate the lid. So you need for that to make a big circle. And to make a really good circle, you can just trace around the outside of the lid. So take your lid, place it on your paper, just like this, and then you can use your crayon to trace around the outside, and that makes a perfect circle. Then you cut that out, you can decorate it and put whatever words you want on it. Maybe you want to label it Sun or Solar System, and then you just use your tape and make a tape roll and tape it on the outside. And then you continue to do that and make all of the different planets on different size lids. So we have done that with a smaller lid and made an Earth, cut around the lid and make an Earth. And well, guess what? There was one planet that was missing from our solar system playset. Do you know which one it was? Did you notice? That's right, it was Mercury. We missed Mercury. So we're gonna make Mercury for our solar system playset to complete it. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna use this lid right here for Mercury. It's a nice size lid, I think. I'm gonna place it on my piece of paper. I have this piece of paper where I cut out a bunch of circles already, and I think that it'll fit right there. That way I don't waste any paper. I'm gonna use a nice dark crayon to go around so I can see that circle really well that I trace. There we go. You can see how it fits right on there. And then I'm gonna cut that out. So here we go, cutting out the circle. You can decorate the circle first before you cut it out, if it's easier for you, or you can cut it out and then decorate it afterwards. So there's my circle and it fits right on the lid. Now I might want to color it in, and I like
to color it in a purple color. That's one of my favorite colors. And I even put a little face on it, and I labeled it Mercury. Now I'm gonna just tape that right on to the lid using my tape. I make a tape roll like that and put that on the back of the tape of the paper. And then I'm going to put that on the lid like this. There we go. Now that will go right into our planetary playset. And now our playset is complete with all of the planets in our family of the sun. I hope you enjoy this fun craft activity. If you want to show us your crafts that you make, you can use the hashtag airandspaceathome, or you can tag our Facebook page. And we'd love to see what you create using these ideas that we're giving you. Thanks for joining us today. Bye-bye.